On date night, something this size would be good. Alright, before we get on with the video, this is a quick PSA. As always, in the description below is a link to buy a shirt from Blue Trail Range. On the back, it says you were never out of the fight. Go order a shirt. It helps the channel. It's all American made, veteran owned. Go order a shirt. Help out the community. Help out the channel. Get off your duff. Go do it. Now. Right now. Click it. And then watch the video. Everyone, welcome back to the channel. Of course, I am Todd with Blue Trail Range, and I am still milking a couple of broken fingers. And the weather outside right now currently is rainy and dreary, and that is why I am not outside shooting, because I cannot get this wet. So, I was pondering, what am I going to do a video on? And luckily, in one of the comments for the last video, Anthony, I'm going to slaughter your last name, Palaccia, asked, so can you do an informative video on what I suggest for EDC for anyone new to getting their pistol permit, or new gun owners? That's a great idea, because I don't have to go shoot, and I can talk about some of the guns that we have here in our rental case, guns that I have, and reasons why I pick certain guns over other guns. All right, so right off the bat, in a lot of videos you guys have seen my P226 Legion. That is not in this list, even though that is part of my EDC. It's a 40 caliber. It's really expensive because it is a Legion. It is not something I recommend for a brand new permit holder to run off and buy for an everyday carry. Plus, most people don't use it for an everyday carry because of the price tag, but the type of finish that's on it and all that good stuff. The social media board that I belong to for Legions, everybody always whines and cries about the coating getting rubbed off. Mine, I don't care. It's a tool. I use the tool. But I digress. So I grabbed a few of mine, and then I grabbed some that we have in the display case. And of course, you already know I'm biased against any manual safeties. I really don't care if you buy one with a manual safety. I don't like them for self-defense or everyday carry. I assume that most people are not going to be diligent in training when it comes to bringing from the holster, clicking that manual safety off, and driving forward. I assume most people are not going to put in those 6,000 plus reps to build that habit of clicking that manual safety off. All right, so what happens is 3 o'clock in the morning, there's a big scary blob silhouette in your home. It's not supposed to be there. You want it to go away. You grab your self-defense gun. You point it, pull the trigger, and nothing happens. And your brain will short-circuit, and everything's going to go wrong because, well, you forgot the manual safety. It's okay, though, because when you start troubleshooting, you're only going to have the rest of your life to figure out what's wrong with that firearm. I prefer point and go, especially for new people. So, right off the bat, this, yes, it is a training gun. It is a Glock 17. It is relatively large. This, I do not suggest for everyday carry. It is a full-size Glock. It is incredibly hard to conceal. All right? Unfortunately, we do have a real Glock 17 that is in our case, but it is out on the range right now for a private lesson. I had to go get one of our training guns. Yeah, it feels good. There's a lot of gun there, so when you're aiming, you're firing, there's not a lot of recoil. It's not bad. It's chambered in 9mm. It's good, but it's not an everyday carry. It is a massive firearm, and if you're a small-framed individual, you're not, you know, fluffy like me or normal, you know, I say normal people, but it's just hard to hide, all right? It's a large pistol. So, a Glock 17, I would not recommend for everyday carry. Remember, you're trying to blend in. You're trying to hide, all right? Next up, and I put them in order of size. It is empty. This is a Glock 19. It has a light on it, which you guys have all seen. You can take the light off. All right, it's got the accessory rail. This happens to be my Glock 19 with a light. I'm a big proponent of lights. Can't have enough. This is good for everyday carry. It's a carry size. You can conceal it. You have to wear maybe a little baggier clothes. It is larger, but it's still small enough to where you can conceal it, but it is also large enough to where, well, you're not going to get a ton of muzzle flip on it, all right? Well, you get that with some smaller guns. You can't go wrong with a Glock 19. It's point and go. Carry size, you can conceal it. Like I said, you can't go wrong with it. If you have the opportunity to get a Glock 19 for an everyday carry, do it. Just jump on it. It literally is the most popular handgun, not only in the United States, but on Earth. You just can't go wrong. I can't speak highly enough. Maybe you don't like Glocks because they're kind of, you know, dumpy looking. They're ugly. They're boxy. Fine. There is an equivalent. You have the Smith & Wesson. It's empty. Security 9. It is also striker fired. This one has no manual safety on it. You can get some that do have manual safeties. This model right here doesn't have one. It is a carry size. It's a little bigger, so if you're smaller framed, you might not be able to conceal it. It's got good contrasting sights, two dots in the back, dot up front, so three dots in a row, you're good to go. It has a Picatinny rail on the bottom, versus the Glock only has an accessory rail. This has a full pick. Takes a lot more things. It's good size. It is 9mm. Again, though, might be a little hard to conceal if you're a smaller statured person. Next up, Glock 43X. Oh, this is really popular too. It's really up there. So the slide is the size of a 43, and the grip is roughly the size of the 19's grip. I'm trying to line it up with one busted hand. So you can see the grips are relatively the same size. If you prefer the grip of the 19, but you like the compactness of the 43, 43X is the way to go. I don't know. Suzanne has one. She loves it. She's got a 43, she's got a 43X, and numerous others. It's good. My only thing that I don't like on this, there's no accessory rail. And I love the flashlight. I love being able to click the flashlight on. So holding something like this, if it was low light, no light, I've got to hold the flashlight up here and then do everything one-handed versus being able to attach the flashlight up front. It is what it is. It's a good size. This is relatively easy to conceal. And I always recommend people conceal. Don't open carry. I don't care if, outside of New England, I don't care if you live in the hills of West Virginia or the nice rolling hills of Tennessee, don't open carry. The big thing now, a lot of people that we hear chattering about is being the gray man and just blending in. That's concealing any firearm that you have. Conceal it. Because you know it's there, you're looking for it. So I always just walk out and I don't tell anybody it's there, and I notice, or I talk to see if the kids notice it or if Suzanne notices it. If they don't notice it, I'm good. I know it's there, but if they don't notice it on me, then I'm good to go. Alright? The equivalent to the 43X, again, if you don't like locks, would be the M&P 9 Shield. Alright, this too is empty. It has a little extension on the mag. It's good. Without the extension, the grip is small. You need the extension on the magazine so it fits, at least my hand. I'm not a big fan of, it has the manual safety on there, and you already know how I'm biased, but I had someone that was interested in this, and I was like, look, it's got the manual safety, you know, you might want to look at something else, and they're like, oh, I just won't turn it on. That's cool, but it's not a big manual safety, much like a 1911, where it's like in your face. It's small, it's subtle, and it could inadvertently get clicked on, and that's even worse because now you're not thinking that it's on, and well, yeah, pull the trigger and it won't work. I never have that manual safety on. You're not going to think about it. But the overall size of the Shield is really good. I know it's really popular with a lot of people. Actually, every single one that I've been showing has been really popular as of late. So the Shield is good. Now we're getting into compact. I'm not a huge fan of subcompact because those are really tiny, but this is the categories. This is about as small as I would go, me personally. So, with that, Glocks are good, but if you know me, you know I am a Sig fanboy. I love Sig Sauer. Obviously, I carry a 226. So this is the P365. This model, you can get it without this. It has the manual safety on, and we've done videos on it. This is nice. Again, though, there's no accessory rail. It's got good night sights on it. It's a good overall gun. It's a little too small for me, but if I were going out for the evening and I really wanted to conceal and really be undercover, armed and like the gray man through and through, something like this in an in-the-waistband holster, very small, very discreet. So I'd wear something like this going out to dinner, or the 43X, more casual, wearing nice clothes, dressing up maybe, going out to dinner with the wife on date night. Something this size would be good. It's a little more discreet. Now, I've shown you all semi-automatics because that's what I like. For the most part, more bullets. I'm a firm believer of more is better. But for all those people out there that are, well, I would use this strictly as backup. But that is me. It's the revolver. This is a Smith & Wesson 38 Special. It's got a very short barrel, very inaccurate for a long distance shot. It only holds 6 rounds versus 43X for here holds 10+1. So it's double action. It can be fired in single action. And that was very uncomfortable on the fingers. This is something I would use as backup, definitely. Something like an ankle holster. I'm not a fan of the revolver, but they have their places. Things that make the revolver slightly better sometimes. This, on the other hand, completely empty. You can push this into something and still pull the trigger, because the action is all back here, has nothing to do with the barrel, which is completely separate. There's no slide, there's nothing to interfere. You can muzzle press this and not have any issues. Guess what? It's a dead trigger, because as you push, it is pushed out of battery. It won't work. That's why I say this is a good backup. Not something I would have as a primary. So Anthony, there you go. That's what I would suggest if you were coming into the store looking for a EDC and you were brand new to the game. I'd say can't go wrong with Glocks, SIGs, M&Ps, so Smith & Wesson basically. CZ has some nice ones. There's a lot of brands out there. It really depends on what you want to do with it. All right. So if you're going to put your life into it, as in your life on the line, using it for everyday carry, personal protection, things like that, I always recommend no manual safeties. That is me. I just assume people aren't going to train. Prove me wrong. If you buy a gun and it's got that manual safety on there, train, and train some more. Otherwise, that is going to get you hurt or worse. I really do prefer just point and go because, well, I have a fear of my brain not working properly, and I just want something that's simple. I point it, and I make the scary thing go away. That's all I really have for this video. I know it's rather quick. I mean, it's rainy outside. I can't shoot. Plus, my hands all busted up and sore because of the weather. So, those were my picks. Let me know what you guys think in the comments below. Let me know if you agree, disagree. If you're indifferent, you just don't care. Or if you think there's certain merits to having that manual safety. Let's go down and discuss. All right? As always, I will see you on the trail. Stay safe and afraid. Goodbye, my friends.